wacky races indeed, because this is the Destruction Derby. You take about 40-odd saloon cars, mix them on the Wimbledon Raceway for as many laps as it takes to get rid of every single car bar one. That's the name of the game. The last one running is the one that wins, and you can do virtually anything you like to get rid of the opposition. 8:01, there's Richard Russell. No, madam, the one in the front is not going to take part. I think he's a brave man, that starting marshal. Let's just hope he can get out of the way in time. Here they come, there's the green flag, and now it's anything goes. Technique, of course, is just to get rid of the others, put them in the fence, turn them over, put them into somebody else, anything you like, but get rid of them as quickly as possible. There's our wacky racer finishing up facing the wrong way. And there's Saucy Sheila in 379 there. And that's one of the two lady drivers. There's the other one. There's the other one. Just gone through. 312. One of the techniques is to reverse into the opposition, the principle being that the front of the opponent's car is more vulnerable than the back of yours. Oh, he stopped. He's tired of that. Oh, tee up. He's going for the fence. And we're beginning to thin a few of them out. Now there's the quick reverse technique we saw there. Rochman and number 93, Blondie Melbourne. He's a former world champion banger racer, number 93. Quick touch, the whack up the backs for 3-4-0. But you see what I was saying a moment or two ago. It's done more damage to him than the guy he was trying to put out. Oh, there's June. Number 312, that's June Tomlinson from Pinner. Very appropriate, I suppose, at the start of this year when sexual equality is the thing. Selection of debris scattered around the track. We're down, I think we've lost at least 50% of the cars at this stage of the proceedings. 312, oh, I was just about to say, 312 looking remarkably unscathed, but I spoke too soon. And that was June. June Tomlinson getting a bit of a bash there. Bonnet on 110. A sort of square dance effect there. Change partners and go the other way. Big tunes in 102. Find behind him, but it's number 29 he was looking for. And sort of in off onto number 4. And there's the overflow hose from 149 is thrashing itself to death there, emitting steam in all directions. Around. That's it, waggle it about and we'll all have some. I think there's about a dozen cars left now, about a dozen. Number 10, Terry Kirk from Raynham, for opposition. That's a good run, that one. That is going very well. Missed. Gotcha. This is really the way to do it, if you can do it. If you can just catch that front wing and smash the front wheel. Boy, he's got, I think, an extra lock on there to turn around like that. Beginning to look a little sick now. Driver's door flapping in the wind. That one's still thrashing around well. It's trying to find enough oomph from your own motor to do the damage to the other one. He's got a sort of very quick exit in case of fire. Oh! I think I'll take that exit. He's had enough. He's had it. I don't blame him. He looks like a Turkish bath in there. Still got number 10, and nobody seems able to stop number 10. I think we're down, in fact, to 1, 2, 3, 4. I think 5 cars are now going. There's 5 still going. Here comes 10. He's got a fair turn of speed there, and he caught 89 on that back corner. Now the question is, has it done enough damage? I thought the days of steam were past. So there's 149. He's still going. And just disappearing from the cloud of steam. Tank is, it was in there somewhere. Has number 10 stopped? Has number 10 stopped? No, he's still going. Number 10 is still going. Don't ask me how, but he is. A bit of retreading of his tyres at the back there. 253 bashing in as well. 149 joining. I think they're all ganging up on number 10 now. Absolutely invincible. I think we've got 4 cars still going, I think. Number 10, 253, 149, and 102. Well, you can't get much closer to the car in front than that, can you? I think 25, I think, has now had it by the look of it. Oh, no, he's not. He's still going. He's not giving up. One, 4, 9. He's just looking around to see what he can find. Trevor Handley from Petersfield. And he found number 10. Five is still going, 149 is going, and 10 is going. Those are the 3. Well, the next time I break down on the motorway with a fuse gone or something, I'll think of these guys keeping going under these conditions. They're a bit like the drunk after the party who wants a fight, but he really hasn't got the coordination or the strength to do anything about it. 149 is out. 149 is out. 149 is out. 10 is still going. And 25 rather, I think, is still going. So we're down now to the final two, number 10 and number 25. There they are. Well, 149 did very well, but it was a little too much for him in the end. And it's these two now to decide. And as you can see, the steering there is stuck, I think, on a sort of right-hand lock. Well, he certainly hasn't got any left-hand lock anyway. Backwards and forwards just to try and find the one spot where the knockout blow could go in. Now, where, oh where, can somebody just get a bit of metal, a bumper, a tyre or something to stop the other one? It's going to be an endurance, I think, here, because it's really a question now of which engine can keep going, which axle can keep going. And I think 10 has had it. I think 10 has had it. Is he going to? I think he's going to concede defeat. 25. Yes, 10 has conceded. 10 has conceded. Number 10, Terry Kirk from Raynham, has conceded defeat to number 25, Alan Stern from Walthamstow. Well, that certainly was a marathon destruction derby, and a fine win for the driver of number 25, Alan Stern.